Hi, this is Dr. K from iMedical School, and here is today's USMLE Step 1 practice question. A 63-year-old male has a past medical history of an unprovoked DVT and gastroesophageal reflux. He is currently anticoagulated on warfarin 3 mg daily and also takes pantoprazole 40 mg daily. He presents with shortness of breath to the emergency department. Evaluation reveals that he has atrial fibrillation with rapid ventricular response. He has started on an antiarrhythmic therapy with amiodarone. What medication interaction should you be cautious of? Is it A, worsening reflux due to decreased pantoprazole bioavailability? B, increase in INR to supratherapeutic levels due to increased warfarin bioavailability? C, decrease in his INR to subtherapeutic levels due to increased warfarin bioavailability. D, increased risk of hypothyroidism due to interaction between pantoprazole and amiodarone. Or E, worsening kidney function due to interaction between pantoprazole and amiodarone. Pause here and think about the question. But if you're ready to go ahead, let's talk about the answer. The crux of this question is understanding how medications can affect one another. Now, there are many mechanisms that can cause interactions between medications. However, the most well-known and commonly tested are those interactions that involve cytochrome P450 isoenzymes. Cytochrome P450 isoenzymes, also called CYP450 isoenzymes, are responsible for metabolizing many medicines. This means that the more active a CYP450 enzyme is, the less bioavailability or amount of drugs present in the bloodstream. The less active CYP450 is, the greater bioavailability or amount of drug is present. CYP450 inducers are those drugs that increase the activity of CYP450 isoenzymes, while CYP450 inhibitors are those that decrease CYP450 activity. There are many CYP450 isoenzymes, and it's not important to memorize which drugs affect which specific isoenzyme, but rather what are the common culprits and their general effects on CYP450. In terms of CYP450 inducers, the most common culprits to know are rifampin, carbamazepine, and St. John's wort. Rifampin is a medication used to treat tuberculosis. Carbamazepine is an anti-seizure medication. Lastly, St. John's wort is a supplement believed to help the liver, though there is no reliable data to support this. The medications that inhibit CYP450 activity include amiodarone, azole antifungals, cimetidine, ritonavir, and grapefruit juice. In our question, our patient's on Coumadin and has been started on amiodarone. Given amiodarone is a CYP450 inhibitor, this results in decreased metabolism of Coumadin, creating greater bioavailability of the drug. The greater the bioavailability, the higher the INR will be and could place him at increased risk of bleeding. Azole antifungals include antifungal medications like fluconazole. In addition, cimetidine is a histamine antagonist used for reflux. Ritonavir is an antiviral drug used to reduce viral replication in HIV. Lastly, grapefruit juice is an important inhibitor to know. While we may check someone's medication list, we may not always remember to ask about how someone's diet may be affecting their medication. Well, that is today's USMLE Step 1 practice question. Please like, share, and subscribe. This is Dr. K from iMedical School, and I'll see you next time.